Hello children, welcome back to Max video classes. In the previous video, we completed exercise 2.2 problems. Now in this video, I'm going to explain exercise 2.3 problems. Let us start first problem. Which of the following will not represent 0? Which of the following will not represent 0? Here 4 options are there. We find a solution each one. First one, A. (1, 0). What is the answer? 1 plus 0. 1 plus 0 is equal to 1. Here the result not equal to 0. The result not equal to 0. Next option, B. 0 into 0. 0 into 0 always 0. 0 into 0 is equal to 0. C1. 0 divided by 2. Already I explained this one. 0 by any number is always 0, and any number by 0 is not defined. Here 0 by 2, 0 by a number is always 0. 0 by any number is always 0. Next, D1. 10 minus 10 divided by 2. First, we simplify numerator. 10 minus 10, that is equal to 0. 0 by 2. Here also same, 0 divided by 0. 0 by any number is always 0. In these 4 options, B, C, D results 0, 0, 0. A result is not a 0. Here in this case, 1 plus 0 is not represent 0. Here in these 4 options, option A does not represent 0. Here answer is 1. Here not a represent 0. We go to next problem. If the product of 2 whole numbers is 0, can we say that one or both of them will be 0? Justify through examples. If the product of 2 whole numbers is 0, can we say that one or both of them will be 0? Justify through examples. First, we see that some examples. We take 2 whole numbers and multiply them. One is a non-zero whole number, another one is 0. 5 into 0. 0. Next one, we take one non-zero whole number and 0. 3 into 0, 0. Here, here 3 into 0, 0. Next, we take 2 whole numbers or zeros. 0 into 0. We observe 3 examples. 5 into 0, 0, 3 into 0, 0, 0 into 0 is equal to 0. Here 0 with any multiplication is 0. Here we observe that 3 examples. We can say that if the product of 2 whole numbers is 0, the product of two whole numbers is 0, when one whole number is 0 or both of them will be 0. We observe the three examples. When we multiply 1 0 with a non-zero whole number is 0 and both of them will be 0. When you multiply 2 zeros, we get 0, and 1 non-zero whole number and 0 by, we get 0. 5 into 0 0, and 0 into 0 0. If the product of two whole numbers is 0, then one or both of them will be 0. One or both of them will be 0. Here the conclusion is, as if the product of two whole numbers is 0, then the one or both of them will be zeros. This is the second one. We go to next problem, that is third one. Once read the question carefully. If the product of two whole numbers is 1, can we say that one or both of them will be 1? Justify through examples. We know that on multiplying any whole number by 1, we get same whole number as the result. Let us start solution. We take some examples. 5 1s are 5, 3 1s are 3, 1 into 0 0, 1 1s are 1. If the product of any two whole numbers, one whole number is 1, another whole number is 5, 5 ones are 5, here 3 ones are 3, 1 into 0 0, 1 ones are 1. In this examples, we observe clearly, if only one number be 1, then the product cannot be 1. Then the product cannot be 1. Here also, if only one number be 1, then the product cannot be 1. Here also, same. Fourth one, 1 ones are 1. If both the numbers are 1, the answer is also 1. If both numbers are 1, then the product is also 1. Hence, the product of two whole numbers will equal to 1. If and only if both whole numbers are 1, both whole numbers are 1, the product also 1. Conclusion, hence the product of two whole numbers will equal to 1 if both whole numbers are 1. Both whole numbers are 1. The product 1. We go to next problem, that is fourth one. Find using distributive property. Find using distributive property. Solve the following product. First one and second one already completed. I explain C, D, E problems. First start C1. What is C1? 824 into 25. We apply the distributive property. We split Here 25 can be written as 20 plus 5. 824 into 20 plus 5. Since by distributive property, A into B plus C is equal to A into B plus A into C. This is A, this is B, this is C. 824 represented by A, 20 is represented by B, 5 is represented by C. We can apply distributive property A into B first. A into B. 824 into 20 plus next A into C. 824 into 5. 824 into 20, how much? 16,480 plus 824 into 5, how much? 4,120. We add these two, 16,480 and 4,120, 20,600, 20,600. This is the C1. Next, D1, 4,275 into 125. Here, two numbers are there. We split into 125 into sum of three numbers, that is 100 plus 20 plus 5. 4,275 into 125 can be written as 100 plus 20 plus 5. This is also distributive property. We apply distributive property. 4,275 into 100 plus next 4,275 into 20 plus 4,275 into 5. How much? 427,500. This is 427,500. Plus 4,275 into 20, how much? 85,500. Plus 4,275 into 5, how much? 21,375. We add these three. 4,27,500 and 85,500 and 21,375. We add these three. 5,34,375. This is the answer. Let us start even E problem. Here 504 into 35. 504 into 35. We split any number. Here 504 into 35. We split 504 sum of two numbers. 500 plus 4. We can change the order. 35 into 504. Here we can change the order. Which property here applies? Commutative property. Since by commutative, A into B is equal to B into A. Next, we can write 500 plus 4, that is 504. We apply the distributive property here. By distributive property, A into B plus C is equal to A into B plus A into C. 35 into 500 plus 35 into 4. 35 into 500. How much? 17,500 plus 35 into 4. 140. We add these to 17,640. This is the even. This is the second chapter. Thank you for watching.